And I think over the years, one of the big things that's changed is that we've gone from a situation where, in essence, the value we were providing to our clients was solving a scarcity problem. There wasn't much information. Nobody really had a framework for analyzing that information, and we provided what information we could get from companies, as well as a way of organizing that information and analyzing it. But there was really very little. And then over the course of the 90s, things changed quite dramatically. And the two biggest changes, I think, have to do with the internet and the sort of the economics of information. It became very cheap. Also, I think over time, by the late 90s and into the early 2000s, companies became more interested in telling their story on sustainability. They began to see, I think, particularly looking at some of the recent studies, we now know that, you know, business-to-consumer companies can get a high return from positioning themselves and acting in a sustainable way. And I think that companies began to see a value in providing this kind of information. And so we went from a situation of scarcity to one in which we were really looking at a large amount of information coming from companies, NGOs, other stakeholders of these companies. And what our clients were looking for was less any information, but really much more a perspective on what the information meant. And I think that is when the business really shifted from information gathering primarily to analysis. And I think that since that time, which I would date to roughly the turn of the century, the analytical side of the ESG or sustainability business has really taken off. And while by no means have we come to the end of that process, we're really just at the very beginning of learning how to identify the key performance indicators that are relevant to these companies, particularly those that are material, collecting the information we need and providing the analysis. But the enterprise of analyzing the sustainability profile of a company has changed dramatically over the last two decades.
But it hasn't become mainstream yet.
Well, it hasn't become fully mainstream yet, but two decades is long enough to I would say take what I would call the long view of this, and looking back over that period, I would say while we're certainly not where we want to be today, we've come a long way. Just to refer to what I mentioned earlier, the fact that companies are interested in reporting information. I would say the ability to analyze this information from the perspective of investment is much greater than it was in the early 1990s. I also think that whereas in the U.S., as compared to Europe, the primary drivers behind sustainable investing were really mutual funds and foundations and so on. Larger institutions, particularly the public pension funds, are now getting more and more engaged. So while it's fair enough that, you know, we're not where we want to be yet, I think we've made a lot of progress, and I think that globally, there's evidence of that. I think what we're looking at is a situation where, over the course of the next 5 to 10 years, we can expect to see, I think, pretty dramatic adoption of sustainability and ESG strategies.